Welcome back. A local trio have earned a Grammy nomination, another one for this guy, for their work on a solo performance. Harpist Yolanda Kondonassis is here. Classical music producer Alan Bice joining us in the studio today. Thank you so much. Boy, beautiful music coming out of that instrument. I mean, you've been doing it for so long, what, 25 years performing?
Oh, longer than that. Yeah. I won't say how much longer.
That's fine. Let's start at 25. Just a couple of harp basics as people who may not be familiar with it. You have the different colored strings on there. Obviously, it's a very large instrument. When you're playing, what are you doing versus some like a guitar or piano that people might be a little more familiar with?
Well, everything is manual on the harp. Yeah. So each string is recycled three times. So all the red ones are C's, all the dark blue or black ones are F's, and each one can be three different pitches. So, and you do that with your feet.
So you have the pedals on there, you can adjust them based on that. So you're not only just playing the string, but you're also controlling
the
pitch on it.
You're a machine operator at the same time.
So you're a multitasker.
Oh, very much.
Yeah. That's amazing. Now, we have a couple of, Alan, you brought a couple of microphones here, special microphones to try and pick up the sound a little better. What is it like recording? Because obviously this nomination is for recording a solo performance in that. So you did it at the Rochester Philharmonic.
Yes, that's correct.
What's the difference between recording like, say, a big orchestra like that versus a solo performance and a live performance?
Well, a couple of things. In an orchestral performance, we don't have to use too many microphones to do that. But when we add a solo instrument, we have to make sure that that instrument is very clearly heard in the balance and texture of the orchestra. And a harp is loud, but it's no match for a 90-piece orchestra.
Right.
So we have to get a microphone fairly close to the instrument. The problem that presents is that the harp playing can be a little noisy up close. And the audience doesn't ever hear that, but the microphone does. So we have to pick exactly the right microphone to make that work.
Do you adjust to her, or do you adjust to them?
No, we adjust to her.
Because it's her performance.
And a little of both. When I'm recording, I play just slightly differently than I would if I'm just live.
Because, as you said, it's very ephemeral of a live performance. Once it's there, it's gone.
You just push it out there to the back row. But when you're recording, you have to be a little more mindful.
A little more precise. I think a lot of people see a harp as more of an orchestral instrument, a group instrument. Mm-hmm. I don't think we see enough solo concertos and performances. I'm sure you would. So it's amazing that to be honored like this against other musicians who have obviously been around for a long time, too. To be honored, it's got to be a great time for you just to know that you're being celebrated like this.
Oh, it's an incredible honor. It's my second time around with a nomination, and I just, you know, there's just no words to describe how nice it is to be, you know, I know they say this a lot, but to be honored by your peers, folks that really know what they're listening to, I mean, that just means the world.
What is the piece that you're actually nominated for? What does that piece mean to you? I know there's a lot of emotion tied to a lot of these pieces.
Oh, absolutely. This is Jennifer Higdon's Harp Concerto, which was commissioned by myself in a consortium of six American orchestras. It definitely took a village because she is fabulous. She's Pulitzer Prize winning, multiple Grammy winning composer. She's very, very hot. So it was a project about 10 years in the making. And it's a very personal concerto because, you know, we talked a lot before it was begun. The third movement, which is gorgeous, the lullaby, is kind of inspired by my relationship with my daughter. So it feels like a very personal piece, and it's just an awesome piece of music. It's in four movements, just rocks, which is what I like to do on the harp. I'm not such an angel harpist. I'm a little bit more of a let's rock and roll harpist.
We want to hear some of it right now. Congratulations, Yolanda, on
the
nomination. Alan, once again, that's four for you, right?
Yes, thank you.
And we'll see you guys, of course, coming up here at the Grammy Awards. And hopefully, now, if history has anything to say, you know, Jason was on last time and then he won.
Okay.
So if history says that you're in on this one, you can see Yolanda and catch your records all over the internet. Best classical instrument solo performance. Yolanda, take it away.